بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، وبعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Tonight, the night of the 22nd of the month of Safar, 1439, after the Hijrah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. بإذنالله تعالى, continuing in the reading of the three fundamental principles by Shaykh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab رحمه الله رحمة واسعة. And we reach in regard to al-Imanu bil-Yawm al-Akhir. And on that note, we took a brief minute to look at the Sharh of Aqidatul Wasatiyya by Shaykh Salih al-Uthaymeen rahimahullah Allahu iyyah. Whereas Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah mentioned al-Imanu bi-fitnat al-qabr wa-adhabihi wa-na'imihi, where it is a fasl where he deal with the belief of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah in regard to believing in the trial and tribulation, in the grave, the punishment of the grave, and likewise the bliss, the enjoyment that is in the grave. And we were looking at the statement when he say فَأَمَّا الْفِتْنَةِ, as in regard to the trial and tribulation in the grave, فَإِنَّ النَّاسَ, that the people, يُفْتَنُونَ فِي قُبُورِهِمْ, that the people will be trial in their grave. The people, فَإِنَّ النَّاسَ يُفْتَنُونَ فِي قُبُورِهِمْ, that they will be trial in their grave. Shaykh Salih al-Uthaymeen rahimahullah explaining, he say, that the statement of Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah وَكَلِمَةُ النَّاسِ عَامٌ, that here the statement of an-nasa, it is something that is general. طيب. And he say, وَظَاهِرُ كَلَامِ الْمُؤَلِّفِ, كَلَامُ الْمُؤَلِّفِ, and the appearing meaning of the statement of Ibn Taymiyyah is, أَنَّ كُلَّ أَحَدٍ حَتَّى الْأَنْبِيَاءِ وَصِدِّيقُونَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالْمُرَابِطُونَ وَغَيْرِ مِنَ الْمُكَلِّفِينَ مِنَ الصِّغَارِ وَالْمَجَانِينَ. وفي هذا تفصيل. He say that in the statement of Ibn Taymiyyah, when he mentioned فَإِنَّ النَّاسَ, but the people, he say here the statement of Ibn Taymiyyah is something that can appear to be general, meaning that everyone will be punished in the grave, everyone will be tried in the grave. He said even the prophets, the truthful ones, the shuhada, the martyrs, والمرابطون, and those who are and is standing firm for the safety of the believers. And other than them, from those who are mukallifin, meaning those who are having given the reason and given the responsibility over their actions. And likewise, wal majaneen, and those who are insane, those who are insane, meaning they are mentally challenged. And he say, وَهَذَا فِيهِ تَفْصِيلٌ, and this statement of Ibn Taymiyyah, it is a detailed explanation that is plausible to be given to. So that is why he mentioned about these type of people that will not be punished in a grave. And we have mentioned with you, وَلِلَّهِ الْحَمْدُ وَالْمِنُّ, four type of people that will not be punished in a grave. خَامِسًا, number five. Number one, Abuba. The Anbiya, أحسنت, Umar, number two. The Siddiqun, Abdullah, number three. The Shuhada, number four. Huh? Yeah, that's the Mara was number four. No, number three. That's what he said. Number four. Al-Murabitun. Al-Murabitun. Meaning those who they are standing for the safety. Let's say they are guarding the believers and they are, alhamdulillah, post, guard post. Right? Post guards or guard post. however you wanna call it. Meaning those who, alhamdulillah, they wanna place their lives on the line for the safety of the believers. They wanna place their lives on the line for the safety of the believers. So bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, khamisan tonight is as-sighar. As-sighar wal-majaneen. As-sighar wal-majaneen. Those who are the youth, and likewise wal-majaneen, those who don't have aql, meaning yani zalat anhum al-aql, that their mind or their intellect yani is away from them. They are mentally challenged. So these two types, meaning the sighar, the children, and likewise the majaneen, those who are yani mentally challenged, he say, هل يفتنون أو لا يفتنون. Shaykh Uthaymeen rahimahullah, he say, and this is, he is not asking, he is asking a question, but here it is what is called a rhetorical question. Meaning it is a question when he asking it, he is not seeking from the people, yes, sure, he is not seeking from the people to give them an answer, right? He is not seeking from the people to give them an answer, but rather, he is captivating their mind. He is giving a little bit of more emphasis into the topic. So he mentioned Hafidhahullah, Jazakallahu khair. He mentioned Hafidhahullah. He say, "Qala ba'du al-ulama." The scholars, some of the scholars, they say, "Innahum yuftanun." He say, some of them say, Shaykh Salih al-Uthaymeen rahimahullah. أي فصل؟ إيش كتاب هذا؟ عندك؟ تيني؟ لا. عقيدة الواسطية. What the man can do. That's what we've been reading for last for the month. Something like that. عليكم السلام. If you have a phone, you can take a picture of it and follow with me, inshallah. Muhammad, send him that picture so he will follow. So he mentioned, وَقَالَ بَعْضُ الْعُلَمَاءِ, and some of the scholars, they say, إِنَّهُمْ يُفْتَنُونَ, that they will be trial in the grave. Why? Because لِدُخُولِهِمْ فِي الْعُمُومِ, because they enter in their generality. The generality was what? أحسن تبارك الله فيك. Very good. Very good. That I have been inspired. I have been given the revelation that you will be what? Trial in your grave. We read that narration. Jazakallah khairan. That I was being given that information that you all would be punished in your grave. So those scholars, they take the hadith ala zahirihi. They take it ala zahirihi. They take it in its apparent form. Tayyib, they will not make no istithna. They will take it ala zahiri in its yani pure form. He say, وَلِأَنَّهُمْ إِذَا سَقَطَ التَّكْلِيفَ عَنْهُمْ فِي حَالِ الْحَيَاةِ فَإِنَّ الْحَالَ الْمَمَاتِ تَخْتَلِفْ حَالَ الْحَيَاةِ. And this is now the point that they bring in. They say, meaning those who say that, yes, the youth, the children, and likewise those who are mentally challenged, they will be punished or they will be tried in the grave. He say, meaning because of لِدُخُولِهِمْ فِي الْعُمُمْ, because they enter in the generality of that hadith. طيب. Number two, is that if the taklifat or the takalluf, if it is being removed during the time in this life because of their intellect being gone, the situation in the grave is not the same as in this life. The situation in the grave, the hal, he say, hal al-hayat, the situation in this life, تختلف حال hayatihi. It is different from the life in the grave. So therefore, because of this, these are talking about two different aspects of life. Because the life on the earth is not like the life in the grave. But they both share the al-hayat. You have the hayatul dunya, wal-hayatul barzakh. Wal-hayatul barzakh. You have the life in this life. And likewise, you have the life in the grave. So this is the reason why some others from the scholars they mention. وَقَالَ بَعْدُهُمْ And the other group, in the other opinion, they say, and the uslub, if you look at this book, the uslub that Shaykh Salih Uthaymin take in this book, it is a particular uslub he take. He will not just tell you what he deemed to be the truth first, but rather he will bring you all the different statements in the topic. And then he will tell you ما ترجح عنده. He will tell you what he is more inclining to, or what is closer to the truth. طيب. So he mentioned حفظه رحمه الله. وقال بعض العلماء. Some other from the scholars they say, إن المجانين والصغار لا يسألون. He say, indeed, those who are the majaneen, those who are mentally challenged, and the youth, they will not be asked. He say, لِأَنَّهُمْ غَيْرُ مُكَلِّفِينَ Because they did not have that responsibility in them. They were not entrusted with anything. You all remember the hadith where the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, رُفِعَ عَنِ الثَّلَاثِ That the pen is lifted upon three. Number one? Naam, al-na'im hatta yastayqidh. A person sleeping until he is up. Number two, Adam? From those who the pen is lifted. Right, the person that is insane upon until he regain his sanity. Number three? Until he hatta. That's the word in the hadith. Ash? Na sigar hatta al atfal hatta. The wording of the hadith. Hatta. Ahsanta hatta yahtalim. Very good. Hatta yahtalim. Very good. Hatta yahtalim. Barakallahu fik. Hatta yahtalim. Until they reach the age of puberty, meaning until they have a dream, a wet dream. Right? So, Rahimahullah, he say, لأنهم, because the majaneen and the sigar, they are not given no responsibility. Meaning in regard to any obligation. The Majnun is not to be fasting, is he? Is he? The Majnun is not to be fasting, is he? Even the sigar, the youth, those who are from the youngsters, the babies and the like, they're not to be fasting. They're not to be fasting. Right, Bubu? For instance, Khadisha, she's not to be fasting. But if she's fast, she'll be rewarded. Right? If she fasts, she is to be rewarded. Why she doesn't fast? Because of what? Adamu an-niyya. Just like the majnoon. Adamu an-niyya. Not having the right intention.